Today's edition of MacVoices is brought to you by Blue Apron. Blue Apron delivers fresh ingredients and recipes to your door so you can cook something new and interesting tonight. Check out this week's menu and get your first three meals free with free shipping by visiting blueapron.com/MacVoices. Blue Apron, a better way to cook.
And by
MacVoices Magazine, our free flipboard magazine that brings you some of the best Mac, iPhone, and iPad productivity tips on the web. High in signal, low in noise, just like MacVoices, MacVoices Magazine includes information on how you can get more out of your Apple technology. Subscribe at macvoices.com/magazine or search for MacVoices Magazine on Flipboard. Welcome to MacVoices. This is the talk of the Apple community, and I'm Chuck Joyner. Folks, this is something I've been looking forward to since last year because we get to start off another Road to Macstock. That means that we get to start it off with Mr. Mike Potter, the organizer. Mike, it's good to see you.
Hello, Chuck. It's great to see you, too.
Yeah, thank you for being here and also for helping us kick off the Road to Macstock series one more time. This is terrific. I'm delighted that we're coming back again for another round.
Well, it's my pleasure. I mean, you know how exciting it was for me to watch Road to Macstock last year? I mean, this was an opportunity for me to see these speakers, many of whom I know personally, many of whom I don't know personally, and then learn a little bit more about them myself.
See, that's funny because I guess the outside world would think that, well, Mike knows everybody and he would have been familiar with all these people. And instead, they send submissions in and you say, okay.
Sounds good.
Yeah. So we're going to go through kind of what you can or are prepared to tell us about this year's Macstock event and something new that Barry will be joining us to talk about. We're not going to have the Midwest Mac Barbecue. This year, we're going to have the Midwest Mac Mingle.
Right. Yes.
It sounds dangerously like a dating game or something. I don't know.
It does. And then combine that with one of the new features that I'm bringing to Macstock this year. And you would think that we're just running a dating service here, but we'll talk about that in a little bit.
Okay. I don't know what that refers to, but I'll be looking forward to it. So let's see, where do we start? I guess we start with the dates and the location. Are we going back to the same place this year?
Yes. Macstock will be held at the same place as the first two Macstocks. This is the third annual Macstock, by the way, I should point out. That is the Luke Conference Center. It's L-U-E-C-H-T, the Luke Conference Center at McHenry County College. It's located in Crystal Lake, Illinois, right on the border of Woodstock, Illinois. Woodstock, of course, is where the name Macstock came from. And it will be held July 15th and 16th, 2017. And what I'm really excited about this year is that Macstock is going to be two full days, as someone on Twitter just said, two full days of nerding out the entire weekend. This is really going to be quite cool.
Oh, that's great. So seriously, two full days. In other words, I should plan on coming home like late Sunday night or early Monday?
Well, that's totally up to you, of course. It's going to run. So check in each day is 8 a.m. And then, of course, we'll have that mingling and, interaction time up until the kickoff each day. And so the actual session times will be from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. each day. So Macstock will actually get out at 5 p.m. on Sunday. I know some folks are going to be heading straight to the airports, heading straight to Midway or O'Hare or wherever immediately after the conference. And some folks are going to be spending the night and probably hanging out together and, just extending the weekend, as it were, as many folks did last year as well.
Yeah. And I mean, that's always part of the fun of it is, not just the event itself, which is terrific, but also the extra events around it and the informal gatherings, right, and that kind of thing. So this year we're doing two full days. Now, Macstock 1 was pretty much one day. Macstock 2 was about 1.5 days. So Now we're into two full days. So you're gradually creeping it up there, Mike. I like this.
Yeah, it's kind of like hard drive space. The more hard drive space you're given, the more data you're going to find yourself accumulating and filling that space with. So, you know, really, Apple is doing us a favor by putting in these smaller SSDs. You know, they're making us concatenate our collection of data, as it were. But no, Macstock is filling up two full days. You know, I can't imagine it getting much larger than that. But you never know. You know, some conferences run 3-4 days. Maybe we'll eventually make our way to 3 days and go from there. But 2 days feels like a right, you know, the right amount of time. And really, we're only adding a few more sessions. We're not adding a whole lot more than what we had before, but we are definitely building in some more networking time, opportunities for people to really connect with the folks who are there, not only other attendees, but the speakers as well.
Yeah, it's a nice problem to have. You've got all these terrific sessions that I want to go see.
Right. But
I also have friends there and new friends that I've just met that I want to go and hang out with a little bit and spend some time. And trying to balance those two out is a bit of a challenge.
Right. And that was some of the feedback that we got from attendees last year specifically, is that they wanted more time to network with the other folks who were there. And so I spent quite a lot of time, probably more time than I should have, working on the schedule this year to make sure that we had enough time for people to do just that. So if you are to include the lunch time, and not Barry's Midwest Mac Mingle, but if you include lunch, which is an excellent opportunity to mingle with folks, and then the break periods I've scheduled in between the talks, folks are going to have over 4 hours of networking time. You know, not downtime, but time where they can actually reach out and interact with the other folks who are there. So I'm really excited about that because I know folks wanted that. And so I'm hoping that this is going to deliver for them.
Yeah, that's great. That's a terrific way to extend the time, but maybe not put so much pressure on you to have more speakers, but, you know, to give the audience something that they all said they wanted.
Right. And yet we do have more speakers. So.
And yet we do have more speakers. Well, before we get to the speakers, let's talk about the cost. So we kind of get all the objective stuff and the information out of the way. What does it cost to attend this year's event?
Oh, okay. Well, right now we're running an early bird special. So one of the things we're doing a little bit different this year is, and again, this is based on attendee feedback, which I take very seriously. Some folks said, hey, you know, I know I had the barbecue. I know that was offered to me. I know that it was part of my ticket, but I couldn't make it for whatever reason. They had to go back to work or they needed to be, you know, attend to some family affairs or what have you. So what we're doing this year is we're offering both a ticket with Barry's Midwest Mac Mingle and a ticket without it. And then the other thing we're doing as well is we're offering single day tickets. And that's something that we never had before either. When you have a 2 day conference, there were a number of folks who last year said, boy, you know, I'd really like to go to Macstock, but I can only go on Saturday. So this year we're addressing that concern as well. So not counting the early bird ticket price, a single day ticket is $89, and that includes the lunch. And of course, you're going to get your T-shirt and you're going to get all the other features, all the speakers of the day that you choose to go. But then we have the premium ticket, which includes Barry's Midwest Mac Mingle, which we'll talk about in a little bit, I know. The regular price of that is $199, and the early bird ticket price right now is $149, so it's $50 off. And then we have the standard ticket that does not include Barry's Midwest Mac Mingle. And that is regular $169, and that's also $50 off right now during the early bird sale, and that's $119. So for a full weekend, two lunches, and then if you get the premium ticket for Barry's Mingle that night as well, it's actually, you know, we're trying to keep this as cost effective as possible because I do understand people are traveling and there's costs involved in that as well. And, you know, make it affordable for folks to come in and attend Macstock.
Well, I almost forgot. Now, when you say this is early bird, how long does the early bird last?
Actually, it's through February 19th.
Okay.
So that's one more week left on that. I have a feeling it might get extended. I know there are some folks who are still trying to work out their travel plans and things like that. And again, I want to accommodate as many people as I can who would like to come to Macstock. but still would like to take advantage of the early bird. So I'm not officially announcing anything at the moment, but I have a feeling that it might get extended just a little bit. And of course, that would include anybody who's tuning into this as well.
Okay. Well, so folks, that means, you know, it's obviously it takes me a little time to get this edited and posted. So, you know.
Right. You have 6 hours.
Yeah. Well, it's a little bit better than that. But by all means, check your date when you're listening or seeing this and, you know, get out there and do it. And you know, got the Midwest MacMingo on my mind. Yes. Mike, people talk about the cost of some of this stuff and they say, well, boy, that's steep. But you look at what you're paying for everything, and you know this is just such a terrific event. I know last year, and this is my smooth transition into the speaker discussion. You had a lot of great speakers. You had such a broad span of topics. You know, you got into right. it. You had a terrific format, which was 20 minutes and out, so that if I wasn't interested in the session, it was on now. I had a 20-minute break, and then I could come back and see something else interesting. So there's so many great things about the format and about the event that, yes, you're right. They're travel expenses, but you're providing meals. You're providing, you know, a fantastic conference space. I feel like I'm justifying your charges, and I don't think I should have to because everything costs money. And if you want quality, you're going to have to pay for it.
Well, I'm glad you mentioned the diversity of topics, because that's one thing I want to make clear as well. So many of these conferences, independent conferences like Macstock, they target one particular segment of the Apple or Mac or iOS using audience. And what Macstock is it's something that's really designed for Apple enthusiasts from all across the board, all experience levels. So we're going to have talks on things like getting the most out of Pages, all the way on up to using Automator to, and it is admittedly a beginner talk, but using Automator for things like manipulating images on your Mac. And then we'll even have some tips and tricks on home automation. And I'm kind of excited about that myself, because home automation is something I've not yet quite dipped my toes into. And I know a lot of other folks haven't either. So to have a couple talks that focus in on that and give you a nice overview of what home automation is and the types of equipment that you can purchase to accomplish that in your home. But then also with the second talk, delve a little bit deeper and find out how you can take better advantage of it. So what I'm trying to do with these talks this year anyway is pair them together where I can, so that if someone is giving a talk on hardware, whether it be mesh networking or what have you, that's going to be paired together with another talk on hardware, so that it feels like one, you know, one cohesive session, even though it's being presented by two different people.
Yeah. I admire you so much for all the topics you took on last year. You took on some that, you know, frankly had no bearing on me. I sat through them and was fascinated by some of the things. So, you know, folks, you got to get out there and come and see all of this great stuff. It truly is. And Mike, you know, I was thinking about it today. You're kind of carrying on a tradition that started with Macworld that, you know, sure, there are a lot of us that are going to show up there that know each other, and it's good to see old friends. But you also meet new friends and people that have never been right. to one of these things before. You're going to find yourself among friends. It's a very, very welcoming atmosphere. It's not, oh, well, you know, who is he or she and what is he or she doing here? No, it's like, come on over and join the conversation. That's what Macstock is. It's what Macworld was, and you're continuing the tradition.
Yeah, and, you know, I will, of course, give full credit to Barry for that initial genesis of the idea. Yes, as we talked about on the show before, we had this idea for Macstock many, many years ago, but his decision to pull together folks from, well, not only, you know, disparate parts of the United States, but other countries as well, to bring them into his backyard for the very first Midwest Mac Barbecue was really the impetus for me to say, hey, let's go ahead and hold Macstock that weekend as well. And that's that first initial, you know, Macstock 2015 one-day conference, which has grown to become what it is today.
So this year, I'm going to jump to the mingle because I know that we don't have a lot of details or you aren't able to give a lot of details yet. But we're not going back to Barry's backyard?
Oh, no. You know, last year the barbecue was actually held on the same grounds as Macstock. And that was nice because we could literally walk out the door and there's the barbecue. We had the tent set up and the barbecue was catered and everything. And that was great. One of the downfalls, of course, of being on a campus, however, a college campus, is that there are certain rules in place. And one thing that Barry wanted for the barbecue that we weren't able to accomplish last year was to have a beer. You know, he wanted to have some microbrews, you know, some nice beer on tap for folks to enjoy along with their barbecue. And that's something we couldn't do. So he was looking for another location, and he actually found a really nice venue. I've used it myself before for other events, and it's called Mix and Mingle, and it's in the Woodstock Square in Woodstock, Illinois. And it's just a short hop down the road from where Macstock is. And what he's going to be doing, and again, I really want Barry to address as much of this as possible because it is his event after all. But it's going to be a little bit different than the barbecue in that there's going to be music. There's going to be live music. He's talking to, I believe, and this is where he can correct me, it's a 70s cover band, which is actually going to be kind of cool. He's going to have drinks, some light bites, some sweets. So really it's going to be kind of an a la carte kind of, well, he's calling it the touch bar, actually, is what he's calling it. And so he's going to have some hors d'oeuvres and some desserts and things like that. And part of the reason he switched it around is because he said, you know, folks were actually so full from the lunch that we had that not as many people ate at the barbecue as he thought might do so. So he thought he'd have appetizers, you know, some light bites to eat and some sweets instead. And I think it's a pretty good idea. And so the mingle is actually going to run from 6 p.m. to 11 p.m. that Saturday night. And it's really just an opportunity to do exactly what the name implies, to get together, to mingle, to come and go as you please, and to just have a great night.
It sounds like a lot of fun. It really does.
Yeah, it should be a lot of fun.
I mean, last year was terrific with the karaoke and all, but right. Unfortunately, with
there's some footage of you out there, I believe.
No, there's no footage of me. No
footage of you.
No, the only footage of me with a microphone in my hand is doing interviews. No, there is no. Now, Don McAllister, that's another matter.
Oh, Don McAllister. Yeah. Yes.
No. There's not. No, there's not enough. Never mind.
If there was any, it's been duly destroyed.
There was not. Trust me, there was not.
This edition of MacVoices is supported by Blue Apron. Fresh ingredients, delicious recipes. Blue Apron is a better way to cook. Blue Apron is not just about delicious food. Oh, of course, the food they deliver and the recipes they come with are indeed delicious. But Blue Apron goes way beyond that. One of their focuses is supporting a more sustainable food system, along with their model that offers you convenience and value. By partnering with over 150 local farms, fisheries, and ranchers across the United States, Blue Apron delivers seafood that is sourced sustainably, meat that is responsibly raised, and farmers that practice regenerative farming. Now that's a lot of buzz phrases, but they are all true. What they mean for you is that by using Blue Apron, you get great food now, and you will get great food in the future, both long-term and short-term. And because Blue Apron ships only what you need for each recipe, there's nothing left over and no food waste. That's something you can't say when you go to the supermarket and buy the portions they want to sell you, not necessarily the portions that you need. While you're cooking responsibly and deliciously, you're also doing something that too many people don't do anymore. Cook at home, together. Whether you are sharing the Blue Apron preparations with your significant other, your family, or your friends, you're sharing the experience. The value of that may be hard to determine, but it is undeniable. So many good things happen when you use Blue Apron, but don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Blue Apron is giving you the chance to experience their fantastic food by giving you 3 meals for free, including free shipping. All you have to do is go to blueapron.com/macvoices, place your order, and in a few days, a package will arrive at your door filled with 3 recipes and all the ingredients to make them. That's when you're going to find out how good Blue Apron is.
Again, that's blueapron.com/MacVoices for 3 free meals and free delivery. Give it a try. You won't be sorry. Blue Apron, a better way to cook. Thanks to Blue Apron for their support of MacVoices. Are we in a position yet to talk about some of the speakers and some of the topics, or is that something we should leave for a little farther down the road?
Oh, no, we can talk about it. In fact, I was really excited to finally have the schedule as near complete as possible and get that announcement out in people's hands just last night. Really, except for a couple speaking slots that have yet to be filled, we're pretty much at a full schedule right now. And you mentioned the 20-minute sessions, and that's pretty much what we're sticking to this year. But I am trying a little experiment in letting a couple speakers have double the time, in essence. So we're going to be having a double session each morning and each afternoon. And it's just to kind of see how that works in comparison to the 20-minute sessions. But they're going to fit in just as nicely with the schedule as the 20-minute sessions and still give people that break time that they're looking for when the sessions are over. I don't know. Where do you want to start? I mean, the speakers that we have is just an amazing list of folks, some of whom have been at Macstock before, some of whom have not spoken at Macstock before. But some of the names that folks may recognize include Dave Hamilton, who spoke at the first Macstock and unfortunately couldn't make it last year, but he's back again this year. We have Jeff Gamet, also is going to be speaking. Allison Sheridan, of course, a good friend of yours. We have Chuck Joyner is going to be joining us.
Oh, boy.
I know folks who watch this channel really like Chuck, so maybe they'd like to come out and see him speak. Guy Searle and Tim Robertson from MyMac.com are going to be there. Also from MyMac is David Cohen. He'll be coming in as well. So, the list just goes on and on. We actually have 20 speakers this year, and I'm really excited about the sessions that are going to be presented. And so I don't know if you want to talk about some of those sessions or if you just want people to discover them themselves, but we've got a full plate.
Okay. Yeah. Throw a couple out. We won't go necessarily run down the whole schedule, but just give us an idea of. I know you alluded to a couple earlier in the interview, but some of the things that maybe you didn't touch on.
Okay. So we're trying to have a nice mix of both Mac and iOS related stuff. So Dave Ginsberg will be back this year. He'll be talking about getting your life a little bit more organized using iOS, and I think that's going to be a nice talk. The duo of Melissa Davis and Jody Spangler are going to be back with another Senior Moments talk. This time they're going to be talking about remote support for seniors. And the thing I like about the talk this year is that it's very applicable to just about everyone who's in attendance, because everyone has at some point in time needed to remotely support a friend, a family member, a coworker, whomever. And what I like about this talk is that, yes, the focus is on supporting seniors, but it's just as applicable to everyone who's watching the talk. And I'm actually kind of interested not only to see their play, their skit that they're going to be doing this year, because I understand that that's going to be the case again, but then to see how that relates to everyone in attendance. This next one with Tim and Guy, I'm going to talk about that in a minute because that's something different as well. But I mentioned the hidden powers of Apple's Pages. Allison is going to be talking about Wunderlist, which she's really excited about. And I know she's done a presentation on that for Don McAllister as well. This one is kind of interesting because we were going to have a talk on this last year and the speaker was not able to make it. But this year, Mike Schmitz is going to be back again, and he's going to be giving us some tips to use your Mac to kind of bring your email under control, as it were. I don't know about you. I have countless email accounts, and I know I have email in there somewhere that goes all the way back to 1998. So, maybe watching Mike's talk will help me bring a little control back into my email life as well. Then in the second day, we're going to have a talk from Dr. Robert Carter. Now, you remember he spoke about accessibility on the Mac last year, and this year he's going to be back again, and he's going to be talking about Braille on both macOS and iOS, how it works, and why it's important to have that feature in these operating systems from Apple. And I think that's going to be a very illuminating and entertaining talk. If you remember last year, he had his Macstock song that he performed. So maybe he'll be back and perform it again. I mentioned the batch image processing with Automator. This is, you know, Kirshen Sia, this is her thing. You know, Automator is her thing. And I think it's nice that she can bring a topic that's as seemingly out of reach for a lot of folks, Automator, and bring it down to the level of the beginner user. You know, hey, don't forget that this very cool tool is on your Mac, and here's some simple things you can do with it. And in her case, she's making it very relatable by talking about image manipulation. And this will be good too. Wally Trewinski is back with Video to Go 2. So he's going to be taking what he began last year, his Video to Go talk, and expanding upon it and bringing some more tips and tricks to the folks in attendance. And you know what was really cool about his talk is he did an impromptu deeper dive, if you will, just outside the auditorium, and people were swarmed around him just to find out more about his topic. So I think folks are really going to enjoy that he's back again this year. And then real quick, one that I'm real excited about is a talk on the Raspberry Pi. This is going to be David Cohen who's going to be presenting this. And this is exciting to me because this kind of goes back to my start with computers. One of the early systems I used was the Sinclair line of computers. And these were, you go out and buy the kit and you put the darn thing together yourself type computers. And then, oh yeah, by the way, you got to program it too. And that's the Raspberry Pi. You know, whether it's running Linux or you're running Raspbian or something like that, these are exciting to me because it's getting kids interested in getting their hands dirty with technology. And I'm really excited to hear that talk. So that's just a sampling. There's plenty more I could cover. But if folks go to macstock2017.com, they can click on schedule and read all the great topics that we've got this year.
I'm excited already, except for one, and that's Wally's, because every time I encounter Wally, I spend money.
It gets expensive, doesn't it?
He always has the best toys, and you know, they're not just toys. They're things that really do make your life easier if you're into shooting video, or whether it's professionally, semi-professionally, or just for yourself. So
right.
You know, just be warned, folks, that Wally has that effect. But the good news is you'll come away happy that you spent the money, but you will have spent the money.
Right. What is that grip he had for the phone? Didn't you buy one of those after Macstock last year?
If you're talking about...
Did you have that already?
I've had that. If you're talking about the iographer.
Yes. The iographer. Yes.
Yes. I've had that now for quite some time. You know,
that's a cool piece of equipment.
It definitely is. Definitely is. Okay, so we've done sessions, we've done speakers, we've done the mingle, we've done the cost, we've done the location and date. What have we missed, Mike?
Oh, gosh, I don't know. You know, one of the ideas I had last year, and I alluded to this earlier as well, is, again, to answer the question of, hey, you know, how can folks find some time to interact with each other? How can they, I don't know. All right. So I came up with this idea last year of how to get people to, you know, reach out to each other and just, you know, talk cool stuff. And so I had this idea of what if we had a swap? You know, what if people brought in the old hardware and books and software that they had sitting around that they have no use for, but that someone else might think is pretty cool and want to add to a collection? Or maybe they say, oh gosh, there's that little connector I need, you know, so we're going to have the Macstock swap, and this is a trading zone. And what this is an opportunity for people to bring in that stuff, you know, to bring in what they might consider, you know, old junk sitting around, and allow other people to take it home with them completely free. So that's the Macstock swap. I think it's going to be kind of interesting. It's new. I don't know if it's going to work. I don't know if it's not going to work. But I think folks, everyone has stuff sitting around. You know, I showed off my blue microphone earlier, and while that may not find its way on the table, I do have FireWire cables sitting around and USB cables. And someone might say, gosh, you know, I really do need that little connector for my Apple Power adapter, or I need that FireWire cable because I'm still using a FireWire backup drive or what have you. And so it's an opportunity for folks to bring in stuff that they're not using, put it out on the table, and for folks to browse that table and take stuff home with them. It's all free. No money is to change hands. It's just a chance to unload and reload with Apple gear.
It's a very cool idea, and it kind of goes to one of the things I love about Macstock, and that is that you're constantly trying things. You know, you're
trying things.
Yeah, you keep what works, and you tweak it a little bit to see if it'll work better, but then you'll throw something completely new into the mix to see how people like it or whether it does work or doesn't work. So I applaud that. I love the idea that Macstock is evolving not just logically, but sort of illogically too.
Well, never let it be said that I am nothing but illogical. I know what we didn't talk about, deeper dives.
Deeper dives.
Talk about things, ideas, new ideas, things to try. And after the first Macstock, people said, hey, are you going to offer multiple tracks? And then we had other people say, no, don't offer multiple tracks because we want to be able to sit in, as you said earlier, on all of the sessions. So I came up with this idea of giving the speakers an opportunity to present a deeper dive. In other words, anyone who is given a presentation has the opportunity to take that presentation and plus it. They're given an extra 20 minutes. They're given a dedicated room and or the main stage where they can delve just a little bit deeper into their topic with the folks who want to learn more about that topic. Wally's presentation was a great example of it. He said, hey, can I do an impromptu deeper dive? I said, sure, by all means. And folks ate it up. They loved it. And then we also had a deeper dive for the senior moments. And Adam Christensen had a deeper dive on his the ball.
Yeah. I know his talk was on STEM. I can't remember the ball
on
name.
On STEM, yeah. But whatever. So he had an opportunity to go a little bit deeper. And we're going to be continuing that this year. So the folks who have their 45-minute sessions, you know, that's that. But then anyone who has a 20-minute session can present a deeper dive. And we're going to have, 2 hours are scheduled for deeper dives, which will give us a total opportunity of, 8 deeper dives that could potentially be presented if folks want to give them. And my experience last year is that folks will. And that the attendees will enjoy them, because that's what happened last year. They had 20 minutes and people were sitting in their 30, 45 minutes listening to these extended sessions, as it were. So we'll see what happens.
Good. That's great. Well, I want to tell folks a little bit about what they can expect to see on MacVoices in conjunction with Macstock. We're going to do our Road to Macstock series again, where once again, we're going to get as many of the speakers on as we possibly can to just do short little discussions about what their topic is going to be, why it's going to be, why they chose it, kind of what you can expect to get out of it. The idea, just like Mike said, is that you'll get to know these folks if you don't already, and if you do, you'll get to hear from them again, and kind of get a Macstock primer, if you will, so that once you get there, you'll have an idea of what you're going to see from that individual. It's always great to connect with these people. A lot of them are on the show regularly, some not as regularly as I'd like. So that's what I'm planning as a way to support Macstock, encourage people to come and see this stuff. Because, you know, it might be that we get somebody on and you really weren't interested in their topic, you thought, until you heard them. And then, wow, I got to go see that, or I got to go to Macstock just to see that person. So Hopefully we can get everybody on. I know sometimes scheduling can be a challenge, but we'll get it done.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun last year, and I really appreciate all the support you've shown to Macstock, Chuck. And something you mentioned the other day, now folks may not know this, but I had the opportunity to see you speak at the Suburban Chicago Apple Users Group on Saturday. You piped in remotely via Skype, and you gave an excellent presentation. Anyone who hasn't seen you present to user group should get that opportunity to do so. But you also mentioned something about Macstock that I'd like to bring up, and that is the wonderful support that Macstock has from the speakers themselves. I think what a lot of folks don't realize is that the folks who come to Macstock and present are volunteering their time. They're volunteering their time, the airfare, the hotel, you know, whatever it costs for them to come out, they're taking that on to be able to put on a great weekend like we've had the past 2 years and will have this year. And I just wanted to thank everybody. Thank you for the work you've done for Road to Macstock. And, of course, thank all the fantastic speakers that we're going to have who are also donating their time, money, and effort to make it a great weekend for everyone who attends.
Thank you for that, and I totally agree. I think that one of the comments that was made was something about they were a little intimidated because it seemed like so many of the speakers and all were podcasters, and some of the attendees were podcasters. And, you know, it's a fair point, but I kind of think that the point is being missed, that these days, first of all, a lot of the journalists that you used to know have moved on to other things, so they can't come to this. Second, it's not in their backyard like Macworld was, so obviously that presents some challenges. But more importantly, pretty much everyone now, from the recognized journalists on down to those of us that don't do it as a full-time thing, have a podcast. I mean, I'm not going to say everybody has a podcast, but a lot of people do because it's their way of getting the information out in a different medium other than just writing. So, yeah, there are going to be a lot of podcasters there. But really, if you go to any tech conference today, you're going to find a lot of podcasters just by the nature of the beast. So if that's intimidating you, please stop it. Come and meet these people, and you'll find out they're just people who enjoy talking about this stuff, and they happen to record it and put it out on the internet.
Right. some friends of mine and I, who happen to record for Mac Eyes Only together all the time, will often get on the phone, and 2 hours later we'll say, you know, that should have been an episode for Mac Eyes Only right there.
Yeah. I think we've done that a couple of times, Mike.
Yes, we have, actually.
Yeah.
You know, I did want to mention one more thing.
Sure.
I briefly mentioned it, and I want to make sure I don't forget it, and that is what Tim Robertson and Guy Searle are doing.
Oh, yeah.
So they're not going to be giving a traditional presentation, as it were. If folks have been to Macstock before, they know that often in between the talks, we had some fantastic giveaways from the likes of McCallie and OWC and things like that. Well, what we're doing this year is rather than have a speaker roundtable as we've done in the past, Tim and Guy are resurrecting. They are bringing back from the grave like a zombie roaming through the halls of Macstock. No, that's not what they're doing. They're bringing back the My Mac game show quiz. This is something they've done at Macworld, and Tim approached me last year and said, hey, can we do this at Macstock? I said, absolutely. So they have got on the first day, right after lunch, they're going to be giving the My Mac game show quiz. And this is an opportunity for them to not only present these questions from stage, but my understanding is Guy is going to run around like a chicken with his head cut off through the audience, getting answers from people and awarding prizes to those who get the correct answers. So I think it's going to be a lot of fun. They said, you know, I have not personally seen it at Macworld, but I've heard other folks say that this is just a blast. And so I'm really excited to have that at Macstock this year as well.
Great. So, wow. So we have a game show added to the roster of things.
A game show added to it. Yes.
Yes. And with Guy and Tim. Yeah, that'll be interesting. No question about it.
Yeah.
After all this, Mike, where do we send people, especially to check out the early bird pricing, but to check out all the speakers, the sessions, everything involved with Macstock? The website for this year is?
Macstock2017.com. Try to keep it as simple as possible.
That sounds good. That sounds good. Well, I hope this isn't your last trip here, because we definitely want to check back in with you as we get as we approach the event to kind of get updates on how things are going and what's going to happen and what may have changed or updated. So, you know, anytime that you have something to say, you're more than welcome to say it here.
Oh, and I'm excited to keep traveling down this road to Macstock, and I can't wait to meet everyone we run into along the way.
Great. It's good to see you, my friend.
Good to see you, too. Thanks, Chuck.
Now, listen, I'm not going to let you get away, though, yet, because I want to make sure that you tell folks where they can find you when you're not doing Macstock. You do a little podcast thing.
I do a little podcast thing. Yes, the podcast is called For Mac Eyes Only, and it's at formaceyesonly.com. And that's F-O-R, but along the way, I actually did register the number for MacEyesOnly.com, too, to make it easier for folks. But it's For Mac Eyes Only, and it's a semi-regular podcast, and we just get it out when we have something cool to talk about. And I understand that someone may be joining me on there whose name is Chuck Joyner soon.
Yeah, I think I heard something about that, yeah.
Yeah. So I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Folks, be warned. Right. Mike, we'll talk to you again real soon.
Okay. Thank you very much, Chuck. I appreciate it.
Folks, I'm Chuck Joyner. This is Mac Voices, and this is the kickoff to the road to Macstock. I hope you will join us for our regular shows as well as the Road to Macstock shows. And I definitely hope you'll join us in July in Chicago, outside of Chicago, just outside of Chicago for Macstock. Until the next time, thanks for watching. Visit MacVoices.com for show notes, links to subscribe, and to connect with Chuck on Twitter, Google+, Facebook, YouTube, Vimeo, SoundCloud, the MacVoices blog, the MacVoices Dispatch, our weekly newsletter, and on MacVoices Magazine, free on Flipboard that helps you do more with your Apple tech. Advertising handled by Backbeat Media at BackbeatMedia.com. Bandwidth provided by CashFly at CashFly.com.